Hello there, fellas. The task today is to machine pockets into here to make these pieces fit. Now, yes, I know it is possible to machine a pocket on the shaper. You just need to drill holes for the inlet and the outlet of the tool. But to be honest, for such a small but deep pocket, it's just not practicable or probably not even possible. We could drill holes in here and file it open, but then again, you would have to make it a lot deeper to have run out for the file. So we need a milling machine, right? Eh, not quite. Now, the last time that I've been using a milling machine must be about three and a half years back. So, I do remember that when you want a pocket of the size X, do not use a size X milling cutter. We want a 6mm pocket, so I've bought a 5mm end mill, and we're going to go in there in two passes, or rather in two steps. Number one is roughing, straight in, straight up, and then we're going to mill out the final contour going around like this to only touch the sides, because if you just plunge in and move like this, then the drill or the milling cutter is going to wander all over the place. If you go this way, then it's going to divert out of the cut like this, and if you're going that way, it's going to divert out like that. So for every time that you feed in, it's going to create a step in one or the other direction, especially with our setup. So that's why we're doing two steps. Also, we're not getting one consistent radius, but rather two smaller radii in the corners, and that's going to help us with the interference between the nose that is milled onto the one part and the pocket we're going to make. Finally, these pieces have a radius right here, and to mimic that, I'm going to chuck up a countersink and countersink the pocket so it doesn't interfere with that. Yeah, I've marked out the coordinates here which I need to ride to. You know, this is just to eliminate any possible confusion, because I am way out of practice on milling. Rightio, here are the two pockets milled. They are very nice fits. I'm pretty happy with how they turned out, especially for the type of setup that I'm using. This is not a rigid setup. And, you know, considering that, the surface finish in here is actually very, very nice and smooth. So, I'm hoping the owner of these parts thinks the same way about it, and I hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you very much for watching, and see you guys next time. Bye-bye!